Hey everyone, and welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create this Mario Brothers kind of looking illustration in both Adobe Ideas, and then we're going to also take it into Photoshop Touch to add some textures and miscellaneous effects to this image. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start laying out my kind of rough sketch here, just kind of lining up everything, just dueling out maybe proportion. I kind of want this like high angle, this very dramatic pose of Mario as he's clinching his this flower that he uses to like get these like firepower from. And what I wanted to do is just kind of lay out some of the anatomy here and just kind of lay out where the hand is gonna be, just do some rough sketches. Notice I'm using a very light blue color. And so what I'm doing is taking this and just kind of flushing out a little bit before I start getting into some of the illustrations. And then what I'm going to do is start kind of inking this out on a different layer. So this way, when I'm done with this, I can just go ahead and turn off my little doodle or my concept sketching behind it. I'm just trying to get the sense of like the weight of the brush. And I mean, I'm using my fingers for the most of this anyway, so you have to excuse me if it's a little rough. Right now, I'm not really concerned too much with like lines overlapping or if there's a hole in a gap or something like that, because I'm going to probably go through, and once this is done, I can take this into Photoshop or Illustrator and really retouch it, or I can even retouch it in Adobe Ideas once I get most of it laid out. So I'm not too concerned if there's a little holes in the gaps or anything else I need to fix right now. I'm just going to try to flush out the main like look of this character and stuff like that. So you can see I'm using a lot of the undos, a lot of the pencil and the eraser. And right now, this is just one layer. I'm going to try to put most of this sketch just on one ink layer. And I can use the other layers for like coloring and shadowing and stuff like that. So I'm just trying to get these fingers correct here. There you go, try to draw a little where his shirt is, where the overalls is. I'm trying to remember how... It's been so long since I've seen somebody actually with overalls. I mean, these are not nipple clamps here. This is the little belt buckle. So excuse me if it started to look a little bit something strange for a bit there. And so there we go. Let's get this kind of leaf. Like I want this branch to kind of be grasping him, almost like it's like a symbiote kind of thing where, you know, he's holding it, but yet at the same time, it's kind of like attached itself to him and it's fueling him this power and something like that. So, and now I'm kind of going through and filling out some of the darker edges, and now I'm going to clean up some of the parts where the lines are intersecting real quick. And the best part about this concept is like I can export this right into Illustrator, and this is still vector. I can scale this up. So at any point I realize I just want to scale this illustration up, I realized I was working too small. I can just keep scaling up because it's vector. So it's nice working in this kind of medium right now, especially when I'm trying to lay out something rough and I want to take it into maybe Photoshop when I'm done with it. So now I'm just kind of lining out some of the detail in here. Let's start picking out some color, kind of outline that like that flame that he's gonna like just kind of emit from his hand. I don't really care much for the outline, so I'm just going to fill this in color, and let's see how this looks with maybe an outline on that, and I don't know, it's kind of rough, it's not feeling, I'm not really crazy about it, so I'm just kind of erase it, and as I erase this, I notice like the little dots are kind of creating this kind of interesting texture effect, you know, I mean, I'm kind of liking what it's doing to the flame, so I'm just going to go ahead and kind of use this, and just kind of go with it. I mean, it's kind of one of those happy accidents, you know? And that happens a lot sometimes when you're drawing. And let's go ahead. I kind of want to give him some really dark shadowing because, you know, here's this flame emitting. Let's give him some really nice dark shadows. Very, just like some hard contrast. I just kind of feel like I want to just put a lot of dark shadows into this scene for some reason. So I'm just kind of filling it out. And once again, I can just go back and clean this up if I need to. I just need to get the rough look of this down. I'm trying to keep those seams of his pants in there, but I think I'm just going to have to go back through and just touch that up later. There we go. Just trying to work around there. I kind of almost thought about leaving this like little piece right here on his side where the light emits, but I'm not liking it. So I'm just going to try this, remove maybe that, and see if this works. No, I'm just... you know, I'm not feeling it. I think I'm just going to fill this thing in, just kind of go dark all the way. He's just going to be very contrast. Instead of blue, he's going to be a little bit darker. So we're going to go more of maybe a simpler color palette here. So let's go ahead and give him some red. Fill that in. Maybe just leave a little bit of white there to kind of simulate light from the flame. You know, let's fill this in here. It's kind of one of those times when I wish Adobe Ideas had a paint bucket, because that would just make things so much easier right now than having to paint in each of these little details. So, hint, hint, Adobe, please. All right, let's fill that in. You know, I'm not... Touch that real quick. I'm just not crazy about the white on his arm right there. I'm just trying to... Nah, let's just go ahead and fill it in all red. Let's just go that way. It's just not working. If it's not working, let's just go with what works. Fill this in. A little more detail. Let's fill that in a little darker. And let's give him some dark coloring into there. Right here. It's a little too dark, so I'll just go ahead and turn on the opacity. There we go. Let's add some shading. So as you notice, I'm kind of making different layers for the different shading passes, because it's a lot easier for me to go back in and adjust where the shadowing is. If this red, dark red was on top of the light red, I couldn't just erase. I'd have to keep getting the paintbrush and the same color and painting in over and over again. So this just makes it easier for me to adjust different things. And I just like all these dark shadows. I'm just going to add some more in here and just kind of clean up that right where the vine is. Add some to the hat. There we go. Let's kind of clean up some of that. Like I said, I'm very messy when I'm first starting this stuff out with my, since I'm painting with my finger right now. I'm trying to add some more contrast to those lines, a little bit darker, a little bit thicker, where the shadows are going to be. Let's fill in the shoes in red. There we go. We're going to kind of keep a simple color palette. And let's just add a little bit of shading on his face, you know, because the light. The flame is emitting from over there. Let's just go ahead and just give a little more shadow. Add some simple color to that. And I don't want the... I'm going to use like a very washed out kind of bluish green, because this whole color palette I'm using right now isn't very dark. It's kind of very... I kind of want to say it's a little... It's not so much washed out, but I just don't want a lot of bright colors. I think red is the brightest color I want in this. So I just kind of want everything else to just kind of blend in. Very simple, very subtle. And we'll just keep some of the white on the side there, kind of like just show a little bit of highlights. And there we go. So I'm going to go ahead and just add a couple more details to this. Okay, so here's the final image. I cleaned it up just a little bit more, added some shadows. And as you can see, I have added some little bit more lighter yellow tint to the flames and everything like that. So what we want to do is now let's go ahead and take this final image into Photoshop. Touch, and we're going to add some really unique color treatments and effects and stuff like that. It's a pretty impressive software. So let's go ahead and export this out to my iPad. And then I'm going to go ahead and launch Photoshop Touch. All right, so now that Photoshop Touch is launched, let's go ahead and import the illustration we export out of Adobe Ideas. Here we go. So here's our nice clean vector illustration. So let's just go ahead and destroy this. Let's go ahead and add some texture. So we'll duplicate this layer over and over again in case I apply some effects I'm experimenting with. I have my original versions to work with. So with this first one, let's go ahead and let's go to adjustments. And I'm going to just use this levels. And I'm going to basically, I kind of want to brighten this parts of it, not really a lot, just a little bit of it. And I want to kind of get a little bit of red coloring in the shadow. I just want that kind of, since it's a flame, and I don't know, I just kind of want some red tint in that shadow right there. But I don't want to get too bright, because I don't want to wash out all my other shading. And let's take the blue down, because I want some yellow into the white area, so it's kind of very washed out. Just kind of a nice, I don't know, just very nice vintage, very color feel to this. So looking very worn. So there it is. So now we have the color for this. And let's go ahead and add, zoom out here. And let's go ahead now and move this bottom layer up to the top above it. So let's go ahead and go up into the effects. And let's choose, let's do a photocopy. And as you notice, we have photocopy. It kind of adds this nice little crackle, a little texture into that dark areas you can see. So let's play with some of the threshold here. And let's change the dark color to like a darkish, a little more red tone. Because, I mean, the black, black is so, I want to add some of this red, very vintage color into it. So I feel like if we add this little bit of a hue, it's going to really help bring out some of the illustration rather than just using just straight black. So let's go ahead and change the blend mode to multiply. Yes. And let's try darken, and let's just take the opacity down a little bit. So now let's drag this other duplicate layer I had of my original image up, and let's apply the halftone effect to it. And you can see I'm going to drag the size down to very small. And once again, I'm going to change the dark color to maybe, I'm thinking more of a bluish color this time. It's a very nice, dark, washed out looking blue. And yeah, I think that should work. Yeah, I think that's going to work really well. Let's go ahead and hit apply. There we go. And so let's go ahead and change the blend mode for this. Let's say multiply. And let's just turn down the opacity a little bit. Don't want it too strong. There we go. And so now we have this really cool like texture to this illustration. It's really kind of coming alive. And so let's go ahead and merge the visible. Notice I had the bottom layer, the little dot turned off. So this way, I always have that backup one. I can always go back through and duplicate. So what I did was I took the one I merged out and duplicated that one several times. And now I'm going to go to the artistic, and I'm going to choose this like kind of paint splatter effect. And it's kind of a really amazing thing. What it does is it takes the color, and it just kind of simulates this paint splatter effect based off what your image looks like. And it's kind of an interesting effect. And what I want to do is I want to increase the density here. And I kind of want it to look like, I don't want the image to be recognizable. So I'm going to bring up the scale and keep the density high. So I just want it to look like somebody just dabbed some paint. Maybe someone's painting this. There we go. It's something that doesn't look too close to what the original image looked like. So we have this. And now I can go into the opacity and turn it down a little bit there. Way down. And we'll change the blend mode to multiply. I just want to kind of just take it down just a little bit. Make it look like somebody drew this like watercolor or something like on a piece of paper. Just trying to like just take it the furthest away from a very vector clean illustration, I guess is the point of this. And there we go. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new empty layer. And with this, I can go up to this little and sign up here and we'll do an add gradient. And I'm going to create this kind of glow effect here. And I want this kind of like light emitting from his flame that he's holding in his hand. So I want it to kind of emit some stuff here. And I'm just going to increase the size. And there we go. Let's go ahead and apply that. So now we have this kind of fading, this gradient effect there. All right. So now I'm going to take another one of the duplicated layers I created. And I'm going to bring it above all the other ones, and I'm going to go ahead and apply this curves to it, or this levels, and I'm going to really just bring up the brightness on this part right here, or this illustration. And so this one is going to be really bright and really saturated. And now, you can see it's above everything else, so I can't see it. I'm going to add a fade to it. And this is what it's going to do, is mask off just the top part, so the rest of it you can't see, but just where the flame is, so that very bright area where I had him emitting a little bit of that glow, and I brighten that up, that's only going to show through right where his hand is. So you can see right there in the preview on the right-hand side, you can kind of see the mask taking shape. And there you go. There's our final image. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and thank you for watching. And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to email me. Thank you, and have a great day.